Hello. Sorry about that. As I was saying, my internet disconnected. I don't really know why. It hasn't done that before. I don't know. It's weird. Maybe it's just more traffic on Friday night or something, I would imagine. Although, who knows? Like, I don't really understand this stuff. Anyway, this map is by Wraith. The thing I was gonna say, it's a more conventional map. It's a pretty well-designed conventional Doom map, I would say. But he has a set out called Alpha Accident, which I guess I'll link in the chat if anyone's interested, because it looks interesting. It has custom enemies and stuff. But there is one thing I wanted to talk about before I go to the last map, which I've streamed before, or which I did a Doom mixtape video on. Oh, I can hit this guy from there? Oh, that's awesome. Let me bring out the chat window again. Hello. Okay, it looks like 15 people are still watching. Oh my god, why am I having so many... I'm dropping a lot of frames. I apologize for that. I don't know what the hell is going on. I don't know what's going on. I don't know what is happening with my connection. I'm sorry. Well, I'm recording this partly for the sake of YouTube anyway, so... I have this, like, on lower set settings deliberately so that I wouldn't drop frames. I feel like my computer and connection are good enough for that not to happen, but it makes no sense to me, honestly. Okay. I will link the thing I'm talking about in the chat. That's like a description of it and everything like that. But there was one thing that I wanted to talk about, and I'll get into it once I start this next map here. Well, it's not the next map, but I guess real quick I'll show you this cathedral map that I like. I mentioned it on a previous stream. I like this opening a lot. This is by Archie, who mostly does slaughter maps now. But yeah, I really like the setting of this map. It has a lot of similarities. I'm kind of shocked by the amount of similarities there are between a lot of these authors, even though I think that Azamail is the most unique of the bunch. But finding this kind of sensibility being echoed means that there's much different community standards in the Russian Doom community than there is in, like, Doom World and stuff. Anyway, I don't want to talk about it too much. We'll just go to map 13. So I did a video about this map, but it bears repeating. This is one of my favorite Doom maps of all time. This and map 22 of Alt? 23, maybe? 23? Called Acid Jazz, are both by the same author, and they're both two of my favorite Doom maps of all time. So I did videos about them, but there's a lot to say about them, both in terms of the mood. I think the music is so perfect. The architecture is really, like, there's some similarity between the Azamail maps, but it's a little more structured and a little less bouncing around reality. But let's get to it. So I can't enter there from now. This has a kind of a extended intro to it, which is the weakest part of the map, but kind of you know, lets you get into it. And I'm really glad that this map is the last map of the set. It makes it really effective. Even though it's not, like, conventionally a boss map or anything. Here it's sort of like you're unpeeling the layers, like you have to do this pedantic kind of going back and forth two different sides of the shape while monsters seem to get stuck there. It adds with that the previous map to this one, which is Dragon Hunter's map that I was showing. I have no idea how to fight these guys. But it adds to that in the sort of feeling like there's this... reality is being controlled and regulated by some sort of system. Can these guys walk out? They can't. Okay. Looks like it's time for some pistol. No. Go away. Damn it. I already played through this map legitimately on the Doom mixtape thing, so. I don't want to just cheat and give myself lots of ammo, but it's a little dicey on a pistol start for sure. I don't know if this was, like, tested on it. Like, I can kill these guys, but it's a little dicey. Oh, here's a little bit more ammo. I'll take it. I really wish I knew what this track was. I really like it. Just trying to get them to infight a little bit. Oops. God damn it. Whatever. People still alive in the chat? You still interested in watching? I haven't seen anything, so I have no idea if I'm like dropping frames all over the place or. It looks okay. But meanwhile, while I'm doing this, yeah, it looks like 12 people are watching. While I'm doing this, I wanted to link something. That I feel like is relevant, and it's a this kind of level design chart drawn up by Robert Yang, who is a game designer, somebody that I know and have worked with on multiple projects. He's a game designer professor at NYU and Parsons. All around really smart guy. He's only like 26 or something. I don't know how young he is. He's super young for how much he's done already. And he posted this chart that's sort of a map of different stages of level design. And the first stage is this beginner stage where it's all this like wild, colorful abstractions, but spaces don't really appear to have much thought behind them or relationship. It's just kind of strange. It's like something a kid might draw. And then there's a intermediate stage, which is like shows basic understanding of form and function in level design, but is kind of boring or uninspired or feels generic. And then there's two other phases. There's like an advanced stage that is a little bit more interesting, basically, but feels more like a generic video game. Let me see if I can actually bring up this. If I can switch to, I'm not sure how to do that. Well, maybe I'll like cut this video so that I can put it up, like, yeah, let's see. Okay, I'm just gonna try this out right now. I think in order to change the, like, the source of the screen, I'm gonna properties. God, I don't know which window this is. Okay, that obviously doesn't work. Settings. Maybe that. Oh, here it is. Doesn't seem to show up. I mean, I'm putting my mouse across it, but it doesn't seem to show up. I mean, I could do like monitor view. Sorry for that glitchiness there. But I don't think it's worth it. So let's just go back to ZDoom. But anyway, the advanced, simpler, more memorable floor plan, good use of patterns, good mix of narrow versus open differentiation, nice mix of height with stairs, but lots of, feels a lot like a video game level, basically. And then there's the expert, which kind of has the ideas of, the same ideas of the intermediate and advanced, but more expanded and a little bit more abstract. But I'd say that a lot of Doom maps really go in either that beginner or intermediate category. I'd say most Doom maps now are kind of in the intermediate to maybe advanced category. As far as like a lot of 1994, 1995, early Doom maps have this reputation for being very kind of hard to parse, or just like wild, kind of amateurish, and that's stuff that would definitely be considered in like the beginner category. And at a certain point, your average Doom map started to look a lot more like the intermediate category, where like it's a bunch of hallways connecting to each other, and it's like there's less of the wild stuff going on, but it's more kind of maybe a little bit more functional and less broken, but loses a lot of the ideas, maybe. I would say, though, that the problem with that I have, that whole schematic map for as a way of thinking about that, I'm not even going to fight these guys, because I don't need to. I wonder if I can... Yeah, this is a good idea. Oh my god, that worked a lot better than I expected. The problem that I have with that whole schematic is that it's kind of a... there is something really interesting about that beginner phase where people have a lot of ideas and they're thinking maybe outside of established modes, and Once you kind of accept maybe a certain way of thinking about things, you lose that. Even as you try and gain it back, it's not something that you can completely gain back. Like, that that experimentation, that kind of sense of whatever, like... And I know that that schematic is more for, like, an industry-type setting, but it reflects a lot of the views and attitudes that I see that... I don't really know how you fit in something like Doom in that setting, because a lot of the things that are very strange about Doom, would you put them... You wouldn't really put them in the beginner category, but you wouldn't necessarily put them in the intermediate or advanced. Like, they're very strange the way things are laid out. They're very unconventional. Maybe there's some narrative element going on there, but especially in Doom 1, like, it's kind of all over the place. And Doom 2, really. And they're more designed to be abstract spaces. Am I supposed to activate something? I forgot. No, this... Oh. Sorry, just figuring out what to do here. So both of these go... Did I activate the switch? Oh, no, I didn't. Something is happening. There we go. Yeah, this is the good area of the map. This is where the map proper starts, and you can see all the storytelling happening. But it's the problem that I have with that whole schematic thing is it's so prescriptive. And it doesn't really capture what's going on in a map set like this, where maybe individual pieces don't appear to make sense or fall into line when you look at them on from a detail-oriented perspective. But when you're actually kind of looking big picture, it becomes actually much more clear what's happening and what's going on. But it means breaking some of those rules. And it doesn't fit within that sort of sensibility or way of thinking about things. And I think that's especially true of things which reflect maybe a non-AAA and maybe also non-Western sort of way of thinking about these things. And the more that you suggest, it's like with music theory, the more that you suggest that someone follows a set of rules before they can break them, the more that you're sort of normalizing that as a way of seeing the world and seeing the way that you approach your art and not really allowing for a multiplicity of perspectives, because even people who are trained within that tradition are always going to think inside that tradition unless they're forced not to. Like, if you're trained within a certain mode of thinking, then it's hard to kind of escape that. You're always going to reflect that in some way. And that's what I find interesting about this, because you play, like, Russian games in particular. A lot of them... And I'm not just talking about, like, Russian Doom mods or whatever, but a lot of them have a different sensibility to them. Like, there's something else going on in them. And that is often viewed in a prescriptive way as bad, but I think often there are a lot of unanswered questions with modern game design, AAA, that kind of stuff, that are answered in something like this, where I say that there's just more creativity, there's more attention to narrative and environmental storytelling in this than, like, true environmental storytelling too, and not just, like, you know, having graffiti on the walls or whatever. But there's more attention to that in this than there is in most or almost any AAA game that's made today. And, you know, like, I don't know. It's just, it's hard to see these sort of ideas being explored in more depth in something like a Doom modding community where stuff like this isn't even necessarily popular, at least outside of Russia. But I'm not just talking about Russian Doom mods, but this is a good example. Like, where do you see this kind of stuff happening, you know? Even in, like, indie games, they don't necessarily explore these kind of ideas in depth, nor have necessarily the resources to do it. Like, sometimes I would say that they explore these types of ideas, but what about something being a mod or whatever makes it less serious? Is it because it's not commercial? Is it because it's dependent on other resources? I don't know. Like, I don't think that we should take these things less seriously, honestly. It's not just about offering a different perspective. It's that, like, maybe there's just more being engaged with here than in most things that we see. And, like, if you just, like, look at the surface in the way that, you know, so much of the culture, especially around video games, does, then you will miss that. And it's sadness both in terms of, like, it misses out on those kinds of things being explored in other facets and other ways, but it's also very erasing for these authors who are actually putting these ideas into their maps and being treated as amateurs, you know? Being treated like they don't know what they're doing, when in fact they know extremely well what they're doing. Perhaps know much more what they're doing than people who think that they know what they're doing. So this is kind of a scary situation to be in here with not much ammo or health here. Maybe I can just cheat here. Sorry. That's the glory of Z-Doom. You can just MDK any monster. MDK is presumably abbreviation, is a reference to the game MDK. It means murder, death, kill. I should look at the chat and see if anyone's actually talking. Sorry. I didn't mean to do that. Nope. Well, I hope that people are actually watching. If not, this video will be up on YouTube. Sorry, I'm just checking the amount of viewers. Okay. Well, it is what it is. I don't know, it's so unimaginative, like, and typical, not just in the Doom community, but the Doom community is a good example. Like, people don't necessarily know a good thing when they see it. They don't necessarily know that something is worth preserving, and what is often praised is often not what it is the most culturally valuable. Because we have to look at these things by just not just being about fun. I mean, I don't even understand how you define fun. Fun is a completely arbitrary terminology for me, because I find this stuff fun and entertaining because it's engaging to me. And yet somehow it does not meet these supposed objective universal standards of what someone might consider to be fun, which is just bullshit. Like, obviously there are sort of power dynamics and other things at play there, but no one wants to talk about that because they just want to buy into the consumer sort of mindset. But also, like, what are we really doing? Like, what is the point if we can't look at something and see it, how it's reflective of culture and how it's reflective of commentary and that stuff? Like, what is the purpose of this? Can you really ever escape something? And if you are escaping, what does that even mean? The fact of the matter is, like, I just don't believe escapism is really a thing. Like, it doesn't exist as far as I'm concerned, because escapism only means you're not really escaping the bounds of your ability to conceptualize the world. You're just indulging in whatever sort of culture and mindset you were raised in is indulged, or in some way, like, normalized or something. And then you have to think, like, well, so what is this really saying? What is it really saying to just play through the same old empowerment fantasies? Like, is that really a goal that is... And it's not that, like, murdering enemies doesn't have to be purely an empowerment fantasy. It might be a commentary on that. There might be something else going on, as there is here. It is something that you can do. And yet, on the other end, I feel like I see people who do their own form of escapism, which is like, oh, we don't want to do an empowerment fantasy, so let's make this kind of, you know, nice, lovely walking simulator type experience, where, you know, the player just has a fun, pleasant experience, and there's almost no friction to it. And I think that, like, there is kind of a form of violence that's happening in games like that, where you miss out on talking about, actual things going on in the world. By reflecting some sort of fantasy, idealized, oftentimes very politically motivated way of looking at things that is often, like, also very Western-centric, and it's also very, like, middle, upper middle class, neoliberal, whatever you want to say. And so maybe there's a politics being echoed here. Maybe there's something... some kind of a statement about humanity. If we get those feelings or intuitions, it means that there's something there. Things don't just exist in a void, you know? There's a reason so many people feel disillusioned with AAA games. It's not just the industrial process that makes them, it's that they're the same narrative over and over and over again. And that didn't used to completely be true anyway. I like how the Lost Souls are... yeah. I mean, I talk so much about the mood of this map in the Doom Mixtape series. I feel strangely isolated because I'm not sure who's even still watching. Like, no one's been commenting in the chat, no one's been saying anything, so... In my own way, I feel kind of off on an island. But this map, like, and some of the Azumail maps, I keep going back to them and trying to understand what's different about them, and maybe I'm just imagining things. Maybe there's, like, something. Okay, here, we're gonna resurrect and then, nice, nice. Wow. I'm sorry. I just float around the map, potentially. I think it, yes, I can fly. I don't know how to fly, though. Oh, there we go. Here's me flying around the map. Is it clip on? Okay. This is the area where I pick up a key here. There's some cool stuff going on here, and there's that like broken geometry. And this is an area that I also think I come out of at some point. Maybe there's a different area. I don't know what this thing, okay, it's just an island. It's kind of like swimming or something. Yeah, this is the outside area where the lost souls all are. I've never actually figured out a way to get out here. I think it's just there for kind of mood or setting. And this goes back up here. This is where I was earlier, I think. Interesting. Okay, yeah. That's the secret that overlooks where I just was. This is a really good map to fly around in. Okay, this is where I started from. You can see it's off from the rest of the map. Can't go down any further. Oh, an archfile, huh? I don't even remember fighting an archfile in this map. I could be wrong. Here's the blue key area. I think this is where all the lava and stuff is. There's a big lava cavern. Yep. Yeah, okay, this is where the archfile is, that's right. I think my favorite area of the map is over here. Yeah. You can see these rockets like flying and all these projectiles. Kind of a like meditative experience, honestly, especially with this music. This is probably my favorite area. It's like this castle staircase that collapses. I think this more kind of, maybe not literally, but in a different way, echoes some of the things that are going on in the Azamael map, the wood prison map especially. And then here is this a big area where you arena where you fight the two spider masterminds. Oh, there's a cyber demon in here. Forgot about that. And I think you like go through this door, yeah. You go through here and oh, okay. And this lowers something down over here or something. I'm just interested in looking at the and there's the this parts of this castle which have collapsed into lava. All these dead monsters. I don't think I killed them. And this goes in down into the lava cavern here too, which is one connection of the spaces that I don't think I saw before. This is where the map more or less ends from my memory. I can't recall exactly. Presumably this is here to keep the lost souls so that they gradually float up and attack you up here. Yeah. Cool map. Anyway, this has been map 13 of Sacrament. I hope you guys got something out of the stream. It's a frustration to me. I want people coming back. So I'll put myself down here so I can actually talk. So yesterday I was feeling kind of depressed, and I decided to go back and play through Sacrament and some of these maps because I've been kind of obsessing over Doom stuff again. And I really think my obsession has a lot to do with very few authors and very few maps. It's really that I see this, like, potential. There's this potential for, like, as somebody who thinks about art and thinks about creativity and how to construct a space that echoes a sort of feeling or mood or like something beyond just being fun, but like a narrative, and it, even beyond like a narrative, but like this, like, some kind of feeling that goes beyond words. And I guess my tendency is to look at this and be like, oh, well, if they can do this, then I can certainly do this. And at one level, yeah, that's certainly true. But at another level, I think, like, there's a reason why maybe there isn't that much stuff out there like this. It's because it's hard. It's actually really hard to do. It's not like they just drank some secret potion or something and, like, it zonked their brains out and, like, you know, made them make this stuff. There's a lot of deliberate attention going into making a map like this. And I don't know. I feel like we reward certain kinds of effort that are often meaningless and intensely devalue, like, other kinds of effort that people spend into making and putting together things like this by erasing it and saying it doesn't fit it within this narrative, so there must be something wrong with it. And I don't know, when I view this in, like, over a period of several years, it's been probably 4 years now since I discovered Alt and Sacrament and stuff, and, you know, I kind of gradually got more and more interested in them. But that 4 years has made me realize there are a lot of interesting Doom sets, but there's nothing like this. Like, there really isn't. And there is something very difficult to replicate, very unique, and very much worthy of, like, continuous discovery. It's almost like if something is so good or so strong, it has such a strong effect, you almost have to sit there and, like, mourn it or something. Like, there's a there's something about it that, like, you have to be able to reflect on in order for you to even conceptualize it. And there's almost like a sort of death in you that it enacts. Like it causes some sort of changing of your perception. And that's almost something that you have to mourn or get past. There's a kind of a violence there that's a more of a silent violence that isn't just the violence of like every day, or in Doom the violence of killing monsters. It's the violence of like reconsidering, you know, what it is to have a relationship with this stuff and what it's really about. And you know, all I can say is, over 4 years, I've definitely tried to consider the possibility that I'm just reading way too much into this stuff. And every time I come out of it thinking, no, I'm just missing more and more details that are in this, that there's more and more stuff that's interesting. So, I don't know, maybe this is like a sort of cathartic opportunity or whatever. Because it makes you see what is necessary. I feel like I've rambled on so much about this, so I might just end the stream now, but hopefully I did my best to try and share this feeling with you. I don't know if it worked, but that's all I can do in the end, so I will run towards this spider demon. Okay. Have a lovely Friday night. Thank you for tuning in. I will see you guys some other time.